I want to do a video because sometimes when we have like a holiday or whatever, I mean, I'm recording this just before Christmas, for instance. You can get to the end of your holiday or a little break, if you have a break, and you might think, oh, what have I done? You know, what have I achieved? So I'm going to give you five or six ideas of what you can do and what you can achieve, okay, over that time. The first thing is I want you to learn how to triangulate a signal. Josh over at Ham Radio Crash Course. Josh did, and we can go to his channel. Let's search for Kiwi SDR. Here we are. This video here. I'll stop it before he starts. Actually, Josh mentions me in here. We used the radio direction finding on Kiwi SDR. It takes you through step by step exactly what to do, how to do it, and he mentions me in it. But only because he heard it from me, because we used Kiwi SDR direction finding to track down who our intentional QRMer is. We've got all the evidence. We just haven't knocked on his door yet. We're saving that for a rainy day. So watch this video, Ham Radio Crash Course, Kiwi SDR. Kiwi SDR. You saw what I do. Watch Josh's thing. Find out how it works. Completely free. You don't need any hardware. You can do it online. Okay, that's the first thing. So if you're bored after your turkey Christmas dinner, whatever, that's a bit of fun for you, isn't it? Right, the other thing I want you to do, or if you're bored stiff again, WinLink. Why don't you send an email over in HF? So here we are. Here's the user programs you can download. I recommend they use WinLink Express. So if you've already got JT65 or Ham Radio Deluxe or anything like that working with your radio, this will work. I've got to tell you that out of all the user forums I've ever been on, I can say that Magic Lantern for Canon, software for Canon cameras, and the WinLink people are the most miserable people I've ever come across. Maybe my questions were wrong, okay? I just couldn't get out. I mean, there's a famous one there. Have you read the documentation? So you're kind of on your own. Just be careful before you ask a question. If it is, be very, very specific and just, you know, bear that in mind. I'm not trying to, I'll just qualify that. I'm not trying to disrespect them. I found it difficult to communicate. So you, maybe it was just me, but I'm, you know, autistic, ADHD and all that stuff. So maybe it was just me. Okay. You can send an email over HF. That's hilarious. Have a go at doing that. The next thing, have you done FT8? If you haven't, I think you ought to have one QSO over the Christmas break. Or if you've already got FT8, revisit the digital modes. Have a go at PSK31. I tell you, the mode I really liked was MFSK16. You can send little thumbnails in that, okay? Have a go at doing that. Document it. Make a little video about it. It's fun. People will like watching that. But have a go at some of the old digital modes. There is a free program called FL Digi. I think Ham Radio Deluxe is free for 30 days. You can have a look at that. I love Ham Radio Deluxe. This is FL Digi. I once got halfway through making a video for FL Digi and found the whole thing really complicated. But maybe that was me. However, that will do all the modes you want, okay? A lot of people ask me what software I run, that logging software. Have a look at N1MM and maybe enter a contest, all right? N1MM, here it is here, all the downloads, tells you what to do. I've done a little introductory to N1MM. I'll put it on screen. And you can do that, see if you can get the voice key working. You can record and play back automatically with N1MM. I've got it working, I just haven't installed it all properly. I was gonna do one of those where record all the numbers and all the letters. So I could do voice contesting without speaking. It's really funny, occasionally I've come across people like that. M0MCX, M0MCX, hello, you are 5 and 9. Number 213, 213, over. Very funny, all right. If all else fails and you don't want to play computers, okay, then I suggest you give yourself a challenge of getting on a new band that you don't normally be on. For instance, might be 160, might be 17 meters. Maybe you don't operate 30 very often. Perhaps a different time of day. Set yourself a challenge of getting up really early one morning, a couple of hours before you normally do. It might still be dark. Get on 40 meters before anybody else in your part of the world is, and call CQ as much power as you can, 100 watts, 10 watts, whatever. See how far you can get. 40 meters very early in the morning. Normally there's some surprises. You'd be surprised. The other thing you could do is have a contact on every band that you've got available. And the other thing is, the last thing that I think is mandatory, if you're having a holiday and you're at home, see if you can get at least one QSO every day. All right, doesn't matter whether it's on 2 meters, 70 centimeters, or 10 meters. I don't care. But challenge yourself to one QSO a day. Get a return on your investment. You've got all this money in front of you. Think about it. If you have a radio that costs $5,000 and you have two QSOs on it, that's cost you $2,500 per QSO. If you have 5,000 contacts, all right, they're a dollar a piece. The radio is now much cheaper. Okay, next video is coming up here. Have a great day, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Bye for now. What a lovely day.